Hey, what's up, guys? It's Malern here, and it is currently 2 in the morning, 1:54 to be exact. So since it's so early and I cannot sleep, I just decided to give you guys a tour of a castle. Now, this isn't my castle, but it's number 16 on the top, what is it, the top crazy houses or whatever, like houses that are just kind of random and out there. And, you know, they're not organized, per se. You know, there's a bunch of cool stuff, and there's a bunch of strange stuff, and it just, you know, combines together to look completely and totally awesome. Now, this castle here is actually one of my friend's houses. He's number 16 on the crazy whatchamacallit list, and his name is Blaze. Now, if you go and look, where is this guy? Where are you? Is that one? I think that's this one. Yeah. If you go in to the castle tours thing, this is the guy who designed this castle. I don't know why he's using those boots though. Those boots aren't all that good. Anyways, moving on. Let's go ahead and get this tour started. Sorry, guys, I'm a little bit tired, you know. I got myself a cup of coffee here, I got myself a glass of V8, and I got myself a glass of water. So let's hope that that's enough to keep me awake during this YouTube video. Alright, so, let's take the mount off because it seems to be blocking a whole bunch of stuff. Now, I asked him how exactly he did stuff like this, and he said it was some sort of glitch. Now, I can't remember exactly what the name of the glitch was. It was like invisible carpet glitch or something, I can't remember exactly. But I think this item here, yeah, the elephant tower, you can buy it in the bazaar occasionally, I'm pretty sure. Let's see. Yeah. Where else can you get it? It doesn't say you can get it anywhere else. Oh, Grip Guardian. Alright. And then he's got some Celestia things there. None of this, like, the lamp, these Celestian columns don't go to there, and the lamp doesn't go to either of them. So, it's a pretty neat glitch if you ask me. Kind of like that because he covered the world gate and, you know, the Zafarian door. And then I don't think you can actually put anything up here, so I think this rug is glitched here too. It's got two little Celestian spires to make it look awesome. Celestian power converters. I need to go and buy some of those, or craft some of those, I'm not sure which one. He's got some of these crystals. Now, I don't know if any of you have seen my crystal farm in the back of my, Sultan's Palace, but I have a couple of them. This guy's got, like, 1,000 of them, and apparently you can get them from sugar crystals, so I will check that out. That's interesting. Very interesting, actually. And then he's got some Wizard City walls surrounding the thing, some storm stone fences. I kind of like how he put the starfishes up, because there's nothing really holding them up in the air, so they're just kind of floating there. I don't know, it just kind of adds to the, you know, the whole Celestian look to it, and it makes it look a little bit more mysterious. And I did not know you could actually come up here. That's awesome. Now, I think my favorite part of actually this entire thing is that up there. I still don't even understand how he got that thing up there. But, oh my god. Like, dude, this guy put so much work into this castle. It kind of looks like one of those billboard signs or whatever that, like, sit outside of Walmart. Except this one is, like, oh my god, this one's with a chalkboard. Think about how annoying that would be when you're driving down the road and all you hear is like a whole bunch of chalkboards and they're just like screeching. You look up and it's a little billboard. Piece of chalk just running across it. I hate that sound. Oof. Alright, so he's got a ton of these things. I mean, I have my fair share of them, but he actually managed to make his look organized. Oh my god. Like, bro. I haven't even seen this part of his castle. He's got a little Triton statue here in the middle. Where do you even get that? I guess I'll be farming Sergeant Skull Splitter later. Got a couple of these fish fountains, or brick wall ponds. Apparently you can buy those too. He's got some of those tree fountains. I have a few of those as well. I mean, they're not really all that difficult to get, so, you know. You can buy them at the bazaar, and I don't know if they're they're definitely dropped. So you can get most of them from, like, Avalonian bosses and, you know, spiral cup gauntlets, so. Bosses that have, like, Wisteria and all. Oh, what's that there? What is this? Me likey. Me didn't see this before either. So we got a little bridge of these spiral thingies. What are the great spiral. This is pretty neat. Wonder if there's one over on the other side. Because I haven't checked over there yet. Yeah, there is. Well, that's cool. Got one over here as well. Let's go over inside here. 3 Zeus Exalted. 3 Meow Yardy. Yeah, see, I think another of my favorite things is the fact that he's got 3 over there and 3 over here. So, like, 3 Zeus Exalted and then 3 Meow Yardy. I wonder if I can... I wonder if it'll let me go in. Without the owner. But... it's crazy and organized at the same time, so I kind of like that. Ah, damn, that sucks. Okay, well, I'm sad now. Okay, I was not completely aware that there was water in this part of the castle. He's got another tree fountain. He's got some more crystals in there. I'm starting to wonder where he's getting all these crystals. Like, does he actually have a sugar crystal garden somewhere? Because if he does, I need to move. Look, he's got like 1,000 of them. He's got, oh my, damn, seriously. He's got himself a little, some dragon spire stuff, some columns. I think all of these are rattle bones. Yeah, I mean, even like whenever the castle is crazy, it's still organized. I like how he did that. And then he was able to put some of the wall hangings on the outside with this glitch. So I'm kind of curious on how he did that. I don't know, like, if you would have had to use like castle blocks or something to do that, because, you know, there's only one thing in reality that you can stick wall hangings on, like, outside of your castle. And that is a castle block. So I'm assuming that somehow, somewhere in that glitch, he used castle blocks to, you know, hang those up there. And by the way, guys, you can craft these, and I don't know if they're dropped from anywhere. Yeah. Now, these guys, ooh, these are so freaking hard to craft. But they're basically like, you can decorate them with your gear and stuff. I might go and craft one and put, like, my Santa suit on it. Anyways. Okay, so it's obvious he spent a ton of time crafting and a ton of time gathering up all of these crystals. Let's see what else he spent a ton of time on. Now, these I think you can just pretty much buy in the bazaar anytime you feel like it in reality. And he's got a ton of these as well, so I'm guessing he went and just kind of... and they're all Meowyardy. All Meowyardy Archmage. It's almost as if he actually specifically went and got a bunch of Meowyardy Archmage ones and then just... you know. I mean, I doubt he even did the entire thing. He probably just, you know, did it the fast way and... went in and went back out. What are these? Black rock shards. Ooh, that's just beautiful. Oh my god. Damn. What? Whoa, wait. What? You can get this item? Oh, damn. I thought that, okay. Well, that sucks. What was it that? Oh, the Celestian Fern. And you can buy these at the bazaar. Star icon, stars, no moon. Oh, okay, so I see what he's doing. Sun icon. He's got some of those, he's got some abalonian things up. I guess it kind of fits in because if you look, it's extremely pink up here, pinkish bluish, so the colors definitely match. I don't know whether I should be worried about the fact that I have friends online right now, or, you know, something more important, maybe. See, I love this. He's got his own little bathtub set up here. Like, he's got his Celestian tub, which is a couple of bananas. He got himself a little coffee table, some, you know, a sink. I don't know what the bobblehead's for, but he's got a bobblehead. He got some rubber duckies. That's awesome, man. I have, like, two or three of these. You can get the recipe in Sardonyx and Silent Market, so two different places. He's got a couple of these things. Ooh. Oh. Well, apparently you can get these drops in a lot of places. I guess it's time for me to start farming. And Polaris, that's for sure. Okay. Well, let's keep going. See, now we've gotten to the moon one. I like what he did here. He combined... Well, okay, so they're not... Those aren't moon. Well, those are sun. That's weird. Does he not have a moon one? I don't know. Well, anyways, so... He kind of made like a pyramid type thing with it. I love that because if you look at it... One star... Oh, I just saw that. One is stars and the other is sun. He's got them like entangled together like they're hugging each other. That's just... kind of cool, actually. I don't know. Like, this guy... Oh, my God. He is freaking beast at, like, housing. I don't... Oh. Ooh. I normally don't like saying that people are better at me at decorating their castles, but... I don't know. I can't complain about this guy's house. I think I'm actually in love with this castle. Like... Oh my God. Woo. The amount of work that this guy spent on this thing. Oh jeez, I just can't imagine. I mean, the amount of time. Let me put this in perspective for you. My botanical gardens, my maze. I don't know if I've showed you my maze or not. But my maze took me about 2.5 months to finish. 2.5, maybe 3. Somewhere along those lines. This castle here, depending on if he actually crafted any of the things in here that he'd have to craft, and all of the farming that's required, and then the fact that he got a lot of the stuff from the, what are they called? Hang on. The furniture sets. 22,500 gold, you know. I don't know. Like, that's a lot of gold farming, that's a lot of farming, that's definitely a lot of farming for reagents. And as far as crafting goes, I mean, sure, he probably did a lot of this with crowns, because, first off, that's a lot of, come on now, that's a lot of crystals. I don't know if he actually got all of these crystals from, you know, a giant sugar crystal garden or anything of the sort. But if he did, you know, all the more power to him. Just saying. Why does he have these up here? I'm so lost. Okay. Oh! See? Oh my God, the glitching though, it's so awesome. And then I really love the Morgant thing. Whenever it's behind these plants, it really kind of blends in, especially with the green bat, like the green bottom here. And then the background, you know, the starry area. Behind the window, behind the glass, is all nice and black, and then it's kind of blackish up here at the top. It blends in perfectly with that little area there. So, like, the plants is at the bottom, and then the stars and the blackness. Oh my God. Whew. I can't even. And then I like how he kind of, you know, it's like he has a bunch of guardians surrounding his bed so that, I don't know, like one of those creepy moments whenever you walk into like that ancient temple and all of the statues or whatever come back, like come to life and start trying to kill you. That's what I feel like whenever I walk in here. Or like one of those awesome TV shows or one of those awesome movies where it's like the Council of the Gods or something, and you got like a whole bunch of like super powerful beings sitting around a table. And they're like yelling at each other across the room trying to discuss how they're gonna save the world. That's another thing that I feel like I'm entering into this room right now. Like this is their godly chamber, and they're all surrounding this dude's bed like freaking creeps. Like maybe this dude's a pawn in the game to save the world, no idea, but this is just awesome. They all have one eyeball, that's lovely. Okay. Oh crap, one more thing I'd like to point out. I don't know if any of you noticed this, but that's wallpaper, and that these are not part of the wallpaper. Oh, and these things also drop from a boss. I'm just gonna go ahead and let you guys know that. Kruin? I don't know how to say that. Charm Tooth Slayer in Celestia. And apparently you can also get him from Carson Sprite Thief during the Lost Pages events. And you can find him in the Floating Land. So, that is the end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I do apologize if my video sounded kind of dull. But it's 2 in the morning. Come on now, give me some credit. I am definitely going to get that Rasputin video up. I have been trying to get Isaac to focus for more than 10 minutes so I can convince him to do another round of the rat. And he actually still needs some stuff on one of his wizards, but, you know, things get a little bit iffy, and he's got a quest on his other wizard, so I don't know if any of you have noticed that I had a few videos up for that looked like they were based in Avalon, which they were, but hopefully, I don't know, like, you know, eventually I'll get to the rat with Isaac in it, and I don't know, I'm thinking that after that, I need to get another one of my book videos up, so I'm going to do that tomorrow. That is definitely on my list of things to do. And I'm also going to be starting a new book, so there's going to be 3 books going at once. I still can't find the other one, so technically it's going to be 2 books. It's going to be The Red Pyramid, which I currently have going, and then Percy Jackson, The Lightning Thief. And I have the entire Percy Jackson series all the way down to the Blood of Olympus. So that should be entertaining. And then eventually I'm going to get that Magnus Chase book. I don't know, I'm just waiting to get some money, you know. I have money, but I don't really have enough to go and spend it on silly things like that, because I still have to pay it, pay money for gasoline to get, you know, drive around to school and to drive to my new job that I just got, which is driving me insane already. Anyways, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, and I'm going to let the Wizard 101 set music play for the next... you know what? I'll give you some music. It's to make sure the audio delay thing doesn't happen. I hate whenever it does that. But it completely and totally messes up the video. So, I'm going to give you guys a kind of release song, I guess. Like, bye kind of music. Ooh, I got one. No idea why I chose this song. It just seemed right for them at the moment. Since I'm tired, maybe something will wake me up. Enjoy. I don't know what you heard about me. Well, you just can't get a dollar out of me. No Cadillac, no perms, you can't see. Then I'm a motherfucking P.I.M.P. I don't know what you heard about me. Well, you just can't get a dollar out of me. No Cadillac, no perms, you can't see. Then I'm a motherfucking P.I.M.P. Now shawty, she in the club, she dancing for dollars. She got a thing for that Gucci, that Fendi, that Prada. That BCBG, Burberry, Dolce and Cabana. She feed them fools fantasies, they pay her cause they want her. I spit a little G, man, and my gang got her. Hour later, I had her ass up in the room.
them trick niggas in the ear saying they think about her. I got the bitch by the bar trying to get a drink about her. She like my style, she like my smile, she like the way I talk. She from the country, then she like me cause I'm from New York. I ain't that nigga trying to holler cause I want some head. I'm that nigga trying to holler cause I want some bread. I could care less how she perform when she in the bed.